I had a coaching client, long distance, that I'm working with for the next 2 months. And in the first session, you are supposed to share your life. You're supposed to share. You're supposed to begin to build a relationship and open up to each other. And normally it should last an hour where he shares and then I share. But he talked for an hour and a half. And that was all right. I didn't stop him because I felt he needed to get something. Because he came to me to help him go to the next level in his manhood. He shared with me that his mother got pregnant in high school. He was born, looks just like his daddy. The mama got married when he was 5. He and the stepdaddy didn't get along. They had other children, you know. So he came in through a rough time. Then they had to live in the housing projects. He went on telling me all the struggles, finances, family, when he got married. His wife already had, come on, just on and on, go, just stuff. Went on, kept on. Told me some stuff that you know, a lot of men would never ever tell. Now, I know he goes to a psychiatrist as well, a psychologist, and so he told me that. He said, I want to try this life coach thing because I feel like you could help me. And number one, I said, well, did you tell your psychologist all of this? He says, no, I didn't feel comfortable telling him, but I felt like I could tell you. Now, the way I helped him is I closed the session by saying, young man, I wrote down notes of what you said the last hour and a half. And let me point out to you, there's about 50-60% of the things that happened to you that happened to me, and I checked them off, and I went down the row, and he said, wow, that means that if you made it all right, I must can make it all right. But he said something that really, really touched me when we hung up. He said, okay, I'll promise to be next Thursday. I'll see you. And he says, well, I guess you know all my dirt now. And I said, well, we all got dirt, and I hung up the phone. But I began to think what he must have been thinking the rest of the day, saying to himself, oh, my God, did I tell too much? Is he going to tell somebody? Will he look at me differently? Come on, y'all hear me? You know, that, oh, Lord, what would he think about me? And later that evening, the Lord laid on my heart to send him a text, and this is what I sent him. I said, you said to me, now I know your dirt. Please remember that God takes your dirt, which ain't nothing but dust, and forms a great man. What are you saying, Pastor? I'm saying that God, brothers, and even sisters can take your dirt. Dirt, stuff that I uncovered, some of it. Some of it I uncovered today. He can take that, and it ain't nothing but dust. And if the God of Genesis, here's the tying together. If he could take dust in Genesis and blow new spirit, pneuma, into the breath, and he became a living soul, I wish somebody would touch a brother up in here and says, God is making you a new man right now. God is forming you into a new person right now. Your dirt has been holding you back, but no longer will you allow your dirt to hold you back. We all got dirt. We all have sin. We've all fallen short of the glory of God. But this morning I say, God, take my dirt. Mold me. Make me after you will. Thank you, Jesus. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I know for a fact that that was the message.